It's Hearts of Iron 4, but not quite the way you remember it. There's no mods here, guys. This is how Hoi 4 looks. Are you guys okay? It's always looked like this. Isn't memory a funny thing? Ethiopia, just the way you remember it. Now we're going to do the historical path. That's right. Reach out to the Italians. This is what actually happened in the war. I bet you don't remember it like that, do you? The Vash's path for Ethiopia. Historical game, by the way. Everything you read on Wikipedia is wrong. As standard, delete all your divisions. Apart from those you can't delete. Fallback line. Oh, this. One division goes here. I don't know what generals we're going to keep, which ones we're going to lose. So we'll go with the reckless guy. Why not? Because we're living on the edge, right? The great retreat. Hold the southern point because they like to attack this point more than any other. And you're good. An opportunity for change. Haile Selassie's confrontational approach to the Italians, combined with his trust in the League of Nations, has led nowhere. It is obvious to everyone that this will be doom for Ethiopia. So we can either side with, I believe, the north or the south, or stick with Haile Selassie. You know what? We'll stick with Haile. Now we sway the warlords. Wow, when you go into the supply map mode. Woof. Like turning the lights on and off. Declare for Italy. Gets an event. Ethiopian civil war. If being at war isn't hard enough, how about have a civil war? Ethiopia well and truly down on its luck. Boom. Ethiopian civil war. This is getting out of hand. Now there's two of them. This part of the focus tree's done, so let's focus on just the same old stuff, I guess. Let's reform our military academy. And now, because we've flipped to fascists, I can spend my political power, so I don't have to worry about my advisors going missing. No, chief of the army. There is none. And political advisors. There's only two. What? Boosh. Ooh, the new national focus. This used to reduce attrition by 30%, but now it reduces by 25%. Out of combat supply, minus 10%, and supply consumption, minus 15%. Oh, that's so good. Yes. Peace. But for how long? I get to take all of Ethiopia? No, not really. We kind of changed size. At one moment where you thought you were winning, and then you're not. Italy's happy though, they've formed their little land bridge through East Africa. Time to restore the country. Give me a massive 20% construction boost. Wow, what's 20% of nothing? Nothing. Exploit time. So we're losing manpower at the minute because we're ticking down because we're not at war. It's the way the manpower system works for Ethiopia. What I'm gonna do is train a bunch of divisions and then make this template nice and big so it eats into all my manpower. So I make it like a little piggy bank of manpower, and then when my mobilization drops down, I can stop training and get all the manpower back. The little piggy bank of manpower. It never runs dry. At this point, we get to choose if we want to side with the Italians to follow the Italian Ethiopian Empire, or we want to rebel against the Italians. That moment where you put your hand out to shake someone's hand and then they swiftly move it away from them and they go, psych! Yeah, that's the path we're going to do today. The Abis Abba Victory Parade. Restore the faith in my illegitimate king, the crowned adder losing stability. Okay, we got to fix that. The Negus of Shiwa. I beg your pardon. Cooperate with the Eritreans. And it gives me a chief of air force giving me ground support. Why? An air force advisor for Ethiopia. Why? Okay, let's reinforce Ethiopian identity. Ethiopia having an identity crisis. Are we fascist? Are we non-aligned? Are we democracy? What gender do we identify as? Please comment your gender below. Set up a customs barrier? Trade? Borders? Brexit? Oh wow, I just read it. This is really bad for Italy. It increases the consumer goods and damages their factory output. Ooh, Mussolini isn't going to be pleased. Increase your autonomy to a satellite. You know, I'm so out of touch with the autonomy system. I don't even know what any of this means anymore. I just tried to trade with the French to get one steel and it instantly canceled. It was just exactly the moment I mentioned before. I put my hand out to shake and they just went yoink. Not again. I think this is the path that Parax didn't want you to go down. No air force designers, no naval designers, no tank designers. One high command and no chief of army, navy, or air force. The forgotten path for Ethiopia. Right, we've got minimum amount of recruitable population. See this? Your manpower low is now 0.5%, and it will go back up to like 3.5% when we're at war. So what I can do now is cancel all of these. And there you go. 200k manpower in the bank. Good to go. Okay, are you going to let me trade steel? Yes. 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 Okay. I think it's time. The Nigusa Nagask This video is 100% getting demonetized. The time has come to rid Kingdom of Ethiopia and the of Italian influence. By declaring our independence, we will soon be the masters of our own fate. Once again, thanks to the leadership of Haile Selassie Gusa. I just realized that there's two Haile Selassies. I think there's a few, isn't there? There are like members of the family. Anyway, war, peace. I told you before, guys, they're practically the same thing. Peace is just a period where you build up for war, right? Oh, wow, and everyone sends us guns, apart from France and Japan and the United States.
Okay.
Damn, I've gotten so many guns from that. Ethiopian honor has been restored. In a rather surprising turn of events, Benito Mussolini has accepted the Ethiopian Declaration of Independence. From this point on, Italy holds no influence over the Ethiopian politics. So all that effort of invading Ethiopia twice, they just like, you know what? We didn't want it anyway. Benito Cognitive Dissonance Mussolini. We'll love the name of this focus. Together for Victory. Oh, it's the name of the DLC. It's like an advert in another DLC. I like the way Paradox thinks. I'm not sure if this is a glitch, but for some reason I can't train these really good militia divisions. This is well and truly the focus path. The Paradox have like focused on the least. Even the communist path is better than this. And that's saying something, because most of the time the communist paths are usually rubbish. I told you that war was inevitable, and it definitely is. Reclaim the empire. Unlocks claims for the empire. Decisions to regain cause and territory ceded to Italy once you're under the Ethiopian control. Once again, gain political power. Yay. Ah, the twins. Very comparable in looks. Not so comparable in stats, though. And we can consolidate East Africa, gains your claims on everything. I guess we just justify for war. Yeah, why not? 135 days? Alrighty then, off we go. We enjoyed our first war against Italy, and then we decided to go for a second one. And in this case, I guess this is the third one. Addicted to Italians. Join the Allies? Why not? Fascists in the Allies? Why not? Successful push in the south? That old glitch where Germany takes the Congo. That glitch has been around since forever. Nice. And we've got options now to reintegrate the states. Jabuda land makes it a core for 20 PP. What a bargain. And also Sidu blah, 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 blah. Yes, all of them, boys. It's really difficult to tell what can land I control and what the enemies control. Is the British flag there in Somaliland? But it's owned by the Italians. I'm so confused. More cores, which is great because it gives me access to more building slots and more manpower. Yay, we've cooperated with the Eritreans, which means we can. Our chief of the Air Force guy. Yay. That's exactly what I wanted, Paradox. Italian depot has been raided, giving me more free guns. It reminds me of the Banshee events for raiding Japanese depots. This focus is unique. Exploit the French weakness. What, are you saying that French people are weak? What the hell? Discrimination. Taking these decisions risks war with the Vichy France. I guess it's to take French Somaliland. Let's give it a go. Break the north. The last port. Oh, wow. Even got an overrun. And then the south crumbles as well. Put them on aggressive. Go, go, go. The north has been liberated. And the south. Call the last two territories. I don't understand this decision. I have to be the owner of French Somaliland. Free France has to exist. Zero divisions in state. France has been split. What? The UK has offered me to join their faction and then kicked me from their faction three times now. You know what? I'm not rejoining. I could join the commentator. No, I'm not going to do that. Must resist. Declare war on Vichy France. I think this decision might be bust. Maybe I'm not understanding it. Regardless, I'm going to declare war anyway. I'm at war with the rest of the Axis. We're already at war with them anyway. Man, they put a lot of divisions here. You got enough divisions here? Huh? You got enough? France is defeated once again. This time in Africa. Okay, we have the option now to take French Somaliland. I don't understand. Vichy France accepts the Ethiopian control of Somaliland. Gained a core and state control. But we're still at war with Vichy France. Something tells me that decision doesn't work the way it should. Well, I want to form the East African Unity. I think this might be bugged as well. It says I don't own much of this land. Mombasa. Oh, so it wants me to push outside of my borders. Okay. The Blue Nile, which is Egypt. Oh, okay, okay. Okay, this is interesting. I guess I gotta go war against the Allies then, aren't I? Britain would like to invite us into the Allies. What, just to kick us again? No. Claim the Blue Nile. Push everywhere. Be aggressive. Take claim states. We have divisions in their territory? We do? Oh, yeah, we do. What are you doing there? Get out. I want to say that this guy has leveled up mighty fine. Mighty, mighty fine. Bold attack is OP. What can I say? Sometimes you get unlucky and sometimes you're killing it. Today, I'm killing it. Declare war. Let's go. Who am I now at war with? Everyone. Well, apart from the Soviet Union. I've got one friend, put it that way. Oh, we've got loads of opportunities to core states. We'll take every opportunity because we need the manpower desperately. Don't forget to connect the railroads. Core them up. Core them up. Core them up. Call it all. Wow, this path gives you a lot of cores. Okay, I'm starting to fall in love with this path now. I'm enjoying it a little bit more than I did before. Grab the ports is so important. That's where all your supply comes from. Otherwise, you're going to have a supply traffic jam nightmare. Wow, this path is so strong. I can core everything in East Africa. What else can I core? I just keep pushing westward and I get more and more cores. This is even more OP than the African Unity one. Wow. Shame the advisors are so, well, non-existent. Look at my manpower. That's insane. I've got half the manpower of Africa. The only one I need is South Darfur. Wow. That's really... Is that even East Africa anymore? The final core, South Darfur. 3, 2, 1. Proclaim East African Unity. It doesn't actually give me anything. It costs 20 political power. And all it does is rename me to Greater Ethiopian Union. Boom. Wow, that was really underwhelming. We get a different flag. Slightly different flag. It costs us political power and it gave us nothing. I've said this once and I'll say it a million times, but one of the big issues with Paradox focus trees is the end goal should have like a payoff, should have a reward. And okay, it's kind of cool to have a different name, but the fact that this gives me no stability, this gives me like no war support, gives me no political power, it doesn't change my traits or anything. That's kind of underwhelming. Eh, it is what it is. And this is what it looks like when I'm at war with everyone. I'll admit, this flag mod is pretty cool, but it is kind of glitchy because apparently I'm Britain. Now, I can say I've completed this. I can honestly, hand on heart, recommend that you never do this. It's like bashing your head against a brick wall. Good day. You've watched it. You can't unwatch it. And keep watching it. This is the next video. Give this one a click. This one.